I added 50 shares today. Yes, I bought. It was like 560. I'll show you the order at the end here, but I do think there's a decent chance of this being the bottom. We'll see how this ages. If high growth gets decimated more, of course, this isn't going to be the bottom, but we did hit the 200-day SMA again today, and we are pretty much oversold on a lot of different time frames. So, yes, we can go down, but I think it's a good idea to add and get as many shares as you can on the way down, because one of these days, the news that we continually getting today, yesterday, this whole last week, the week before that, the last month, we keep going down. Stop price keeps going down. Fundamental value only increases. So I've got a lot of good things to talk about today. Actually, we got this PR right here. This is the CGC meeting. That's actually really exciting. There's a couple quotes in there. And the marketing and sales opportunity there that is very important. We have the Medicare thing. That is happening. That's happening tomorrow. That literally starts tomorrow. We also have another. I was a little bit late on this one because this is from July 25th. And I'm just now finding out about this now because I checked my email late. But this essentially is another Saphyr sale, to my understanding. I haven't fact-checked everything, but to my understanding, this is another Saphyr sale that happened sometime recently. I don't know if this is like last couple days. It could be in quarter two. Hell, I guess technically it could be quarter one. That's pretty much possible. But this is a recent Saphyr sale that we're going to go over on how I think I know that, or at least rental agreement, right? One of the two. There's the study itself. And then we have a fair amount of new filings there. We're going to go over those, of course. Short interest data is actually decreased a lot. We're going to go over there. Details there. Quarter two earnings. This is coming August 12th. Okay. I said it was going to be August 13th. And before that, I said it was going to be August 23rd. Both of those are wrong. I got it wrong again. It's August 12th. According to NASDAQ, I think the NASDAQ's, this is what we're looking at. Okay. It could be wrong, but this isn't the official date, but this is what we're expecting the earnings to be. August 12th. So, and then, I'm going to reiterate my expectations there. We'll go over a little bit of price action, some technical analysis, and my order, where I actually show you how many shares I added today. It was a fair amount, I would say. It is my philosophy that adding as we're going down, get as many shares as you can as we're going down. When the company value increases, long term, you're going to be rewarded. Simple as it gets. Now, first piece of news. This is freaking interesting. Now, if we look down here, the first thing to note is that there's 500 participants in 2020. This year, there's higher anticipation for it. That's beautiful. And the reason is because we have also, look at this bad boy right here. This is a little bit of a spoiler and a hint as to what you may be seeing in the next few days when I research this a little more. University of South Alabama, that might be another Saphyr sale or rental agreement on top of the check Saphyr sale that we just got through this news that we got 2 days ago. So that's another thing. But for this piece, this is going to be marketing. 10 institutions or seven of them-ish. Seven to eight-ish institutions. There's a couple repeats in here that are going to be presenting solid tumor analysis, hematological malignancies, everything. Okay, prenatal, postnatal, everything. They're doing, okay, products of conception. Are you kidding me? I mean, they're doing everything. All right, they're doing stuff we don't even know about or talk about that much. And that's beautiful. It's going to be marketing. It's going to be sales. And if we look at the quote here, it's by our chief medical officer, Al Kachabi, and our CEO, Eric Holman. Now, look at this first one. Thrilled to see the broad adoption of optical genome mapping. It's always great to see their confidence in the broad adoption and the global adoption and the progress of the sales, essentially, of optical genome mapping by members of the CGC community, Cancer Genomics Consortium. That's the whole platform that this is going on, of clinical researchers who have rigorously compared, yada, yada, OGM is better than karyotyping. We know it. I like how she points out, though, in all the presentations, there are reoccurring themes of increased sensitivity, higher success rates, and an easier workflow using us compared to the other guys, right? And clinically relevant structural variants, we are better than them, simple as it gets, right? So you love to see it. And then the CEO, let's go down here. We believe this multitude of presentations shows how significant Bionano's pressure and that of OGM has become in the cancer research community. The progress we are seeing here within the U.S. market with all the OGM data being presented at the CGC meeting is extremely encouraging and further reinforces our belief in the value proposition of our solution. I like that. I like it a lot. I like this PR. Obviously, the price goes down when we get good PR, but long-term, this is just a buying opportunity. That's as simple as it gets, right? Now, if we look here, there's a lot of tweets today. These are all pretty much about the stuff going on tomorrow, or not tomorrow, on August 1st to 4th. And this whole thing, and this meeting, by the way, I don't know why I didn't say this, it's happening August 1st to 4th, right? So they tweeted a lot today about when the process is going to happen. Okay, whatever, we don't really care. That's cool. We want it to be, it's going to be marketing. We don't really know that. We don't really need to know that, though. However, the Medicare, getting Saphyr covered by Medicare, to my understanding, that would be huge for sales. That would likely increase sales in the aggregate in a huge way, very significant way. The proclivity for institutions to actually adopt the Saphyr system, it's way higher. It's going to proliferate that process undeniably. Now, if we look at this tweet right here, and that's happening tomorrow. I keep forgetting the dates. Tomorrow and the next day. That's beautiful. That's and what is actually happening is this panel is going to be talking about who gets what, and if they're going to get it, if they're going to get Medicare coverage. To my understanding, an optical genome mapping is listed there several times. We've already gone over that. Now this thing right here, this is beautiful. This is the Czech university or whatever. This university right here, they're located in Czech, not Czech University. This is however you pronounce this university here. Okay. They're located in Czech. And I did a little bit of research here. To my understanding, these guys have not used a Saphyr before. And also to my understanding, these guys as well, University of South Alabama, neither of those. It's University of South Alabama and the University of whatever in Czech. Those are two institutions or whatever you want to call them, right? I call them institutions because it's easy to call them all that. Two places have used the Saphyr that have not used one previously to the public's knowledge. That's as simple as it gets. Very likely rental agreements or sales that happened recently, quarter three, quarter two, both are on the table. So you love to see it. You absolutely love to see it. That's what you want to see as a shareholder: sales coming in, revenue, money. We want to make money. That's how the only way we make money is if the freaking company's sales makes money. And you love to see it. This study right here is beautiful. Okay, I didn't read all this, but you know, it's just more proof of concept. I don't think we need any more proof of concept at this point. Okay, you're talking about bone marrow cells at this point. Like what? I don't even, what the hell does this stuff even mean, bro? I don't even know. This is great. Chromosome abnormalities, right? It's more of a proof of concept, application proof that we have more applications than we currently are, you know, supposed to be used right now for. Only a couple that we do, we can be used. You know, they don't have bone marrow myeloma cells. They don't have this listed on the applications of Saphyr on the website, right? This is the extensive and very versatile and broad and vast applications of the Saphyr and uses of the Saphyr, right? So it's beautiful. Now, if we look at the filings today, you're basically looking at an institution selling out 500 shares. They sold 500 shares, but what I actually like, the only one of note, in my opinion, is going to be this bad boy right here, this 13F filing, or the MP filing, my bad. Its effective date is May 28th. They somehow have an average price of $3.77, although the May 28th was like $7 a share or $6 a share. Whatever, there's a nice disparity there. It doesn't make sense at all. But they added 72,000 shares for the first time, and as of now, they are holding. Also, notice the portfolio allocation is not looking, that's not what you want. You know, you want 0.1 or higher, but it's almost 0.1%. That's not bad. And also, look at who it is. Goldman Sachs Innovation Equity ETF. That's beautiful right there. And the reason why that's great is because we want to be in those. We want to be included in the ETFs that are going to be innovation, disruptiveness. I like that they're holding. I like that they bought on that the effective date is May 28th. And to my understanding, that's going to be their buy date. That's going to be the transaction date. And their average price is actually much higher than 377, which means they're holding through this downtrend, which means they have high confidence. That should mean maybe we should have a little bit more confidence as well. Maybe, right? You need to do your own research. Trust your own research than one institution on Fintel. Definitely, but still, it's good to know. Now, short interest data on the day. 15% of the flow sold short, 42 million shares. It's decreased overall, actually, in the last few weeks. It's decreased, which I don't like that. I would rather this... Like for the future, for the best short-term stop price or even midterm, I would rather this be higher and closer to 22%. Now, this is only what's reported. It could be fucking 30% or 25% or 20 or something crazy like that. And they don't give us it because they don't get. Oh, they only get like 85% of the data from the exchanges. 15% could be low, but still, it's slightly bearish. I wouldn't say it. At the end of the day, the company sales is going to matter more than the short interest. So it's something to know, though. I kind of tried to make that point because I'm trying to tell you, I'm not just giving you the bullish stuff. I'm telling you, I'm trying to call it both ways. I'm trying to give you both sides of the coin as best I can. Now, the earnings, this is coming out, and my expectations are right here. You can write them down. You can go look at the post. I've talked about this probably a myriad of times. You're probably tired of hearing it at this point, right? 4 million for the base case scenario, 3.5 million for the bear case. Yeah, you heard that right. That's the consensus right now as well. The consensus estimate from Wall Street, to my knowledge, last I saw, 3.5 million. That's what you're looking at. And my base case is 4 million. That should tell you about how I'm thinking about earnings, right? Simple as it gets. Now, the date for earnings, as we said, you're looking at August 12th, right? So that's, what is that? That's 15 days, right? 15, 16 days, something like that. It's almost time. It's almost time to start the moon. And I can't. And the title for the video, when we do the stream, it's gonna be "It is time." BNGO stock. It is time. And what is the time to do? Well, just think of the thumbnail. That's what I'll tell you there. And as I'm saying that, of course, the irony never fails. We're dumping after hours. But remember, earnings earnings is the most important thing for the price, for the price and for the company. It tells us so. So I would just have a, just to understand the difference between high growth going down and the company's value going down 100%. Now for the technical analysis, we'll just do some quick technical analysis here. Still oversold in the stochastic indicator in the 4 hour. You're still getting a buy signal there. Still getting a buy signal. Now on the daily chart, if you look at the SMA on the 200 day SMA and the 200 day EMA, you're getting, I mean, we got a bounce today. We have a doji. We do have a doji candle, which is basically, I mean, that is, you're looking at a doji right there when it's high wick up, high wick down, or it can be a small wick and there's, and the price doesn't really move, right? It opens here, closes here. It's the, it's indecision. It's price action indecision. This is one of the great, like one of the best candles to form, and one of the one that there's a high proclivity for forming before a reversal, right? Okay, you can go up a ton, right? You can go up a ton and then have a doji, and then you have your little doji right there. Okay, that's a horrible doji. You know what I mean? And then there you go. Yeah, there's your reversal. Likewise, you can go down, or conversely, I should say. You go down, your doji's right there. Horrible doji again. That's even worse. And then you reverse, right? That's very often what we see. And you see that one good example that I see in the recent past right there. There's your doji. And then there you go. That's your indecision. That's your signal that the price action is the bears are losing control, or whoever currently holds the momentum, which in this case would be the bears, who we've gone down like 4 days in a row. They're losing momentum. The bulls are starting to catch up, and momentum switch might be coming soon. Given the fact that last time we bounced off the 200-day SMA very nicely, and actually the last time before that as well, yes, there is a case that this is going to be the bottom and that we are still forming higher lows, believe it or not. We are forming lower highs, but we're also forming higher lows. So it's like this could still be an uptrend as long as we are above the 200-day SMA. From a technical standpoint, you're still in an uptrend macroscopically. And also, let me let you in a secret. Let me let you in on a little bit of a secret here. It doesn't matter where these lines are. If the earnings is 5 million or 4 million, we're going way up to $8 or $7. Probably, in my opinion, we're going to $8 easily if we get 4 million or 5 million. That's as simple as it gets in my book. Now we'll see what happens, but that's just what I'm thinking. Down 2% after hours, the irony could not be better. But I did, and let me go ahead and show you the orders for the day. So and that's what I'll say for the technical analysis, right? You're pretty oversold on the daily stochastic and the RSI. Not horribly, not like you're not neutral, you're not oversold yet, though you're pretty close oversold. So, and it's my opinion that buying when we're getting annihilated, you want to buy. You want to be greedy when everyone else is fearful and selling and everyone says it's such a shit company, that's when you buy. And then when you get the euphoria, that's when you chill out and you sell a little bit and you get that buying power ready to pounce once it comes down. That's as simple as it gets. Now, if we look at the orders, you're looking at 52 shares. Yeah, 52 shares, and then your prices are 560, and then 560s is where I bought at today. And we'll see. JP is talking tomorrow. That's why I still have a little bit of UBSY, as you can see. There you go, right there. And with that being said, thank you so much. It's not Finish Weissman. I will see y'all in the next one.